The Bureau of Industry and Security presents Deemed Exports.
We finally hired an engineer, and he's from Japan.
That's great news. Will we need to apply for a deemed export license for the new hire?
What is a deemed export license?
A deemed export license is an authorization from the Department of Commerce to release technology or source code subject to the Export Administration Regulations to a foreign person in the United States. The release is deemed to be an export to the individual's most recently obtained citizenship or permanent residence.
How do I figure that out?
Sounds like I should set up a deemed export training session. Thank you for joining this training session. Today, we are going to discuss the deemed export provision in Part 734 of the Export Administration Regulations, or EAR for short. Similar to how a license might be required to export items from the United States to a foreign country, a license might be required to release technology or source code to a foreign person in the United States. A release may occur through visual inspection, verbal exchange, or the review of technical data, plans, or blueprints. Bear in mind that a foreign person's simple operation or use of an item subject to the EAR is not necessarily a release of technology. A foreign person is defined in Part 772 of the EAR. The term encompasses a natural person who is not a lawful permanent resident of the United States, citizen of the United States, or any other protected individual. In addition, foreign person is synonymous with foreign national as used in the EAR and foreign person as used in the International Traffic in Arms Regulations. A release of technology or source code is considered an export of that item to a foreign person's most recently acquired country of citizenship or permanent residency. Releasing technology or source code to that individual in the United States would be deemed an export to that foreign country for which authorization from BIS might be required. There may be situations in which a foreign person possesses more than one citizenship or country of permanent residence. In such situations, BIS will base the license requirements on his or her most recently acquired country of citizenship or permanent residency. For example, suppose you are designing an optical mirror and would like to hire an engineer from Japan to join your U.S. development team. You must confirm the individual's immigration status, that is, confirm his citizenship and or any permanent residencies he or she might possess. If the engineer's most recent country of citizenship or permanent residency is Japan, the release of the design technology in the U.S. to the engineer would be deemed an export to Japan. Not all releases of technology or source code require authorization from BIS. Depending on the item at issue and the country of most recent citizenship or permanent residence, the export may qualify for a license exception or be eligible for no license required or NLR treatment. I recommend watching Export Controls, a quick start guide available in the BIS online training room for more information on licenses, license exceptions, and the NLR designation. Let's take a closer look at the optical mirror example. Certain optical mirrors are controlled on the Commerce Control List under Export Control Classification Number ECCN 6A004. For this example, let's assume the optical mirrors are controlled under ECCN 6A004.A. Therefore, the development technology for these optical mirrors is controlled under ECCN 6E001. Now let's figure out the reasons for control. The development technology is controlled for national security column 1 reasons and anti-terrorism column 1 reasons. Let's take a look at the commerce country chart. Is there a license requirement to release the development technology to Japan? Cross-reference the row for Japan with the columns of the applicable reasons for control. In this case, national security column 1 and anti-terrorism column 1. Since there is an X in the box under the National Security Column 1 reasons for Japan, you will need to apply for a license and receive an approval, unless a license exception is available, prior to the release of the technology to the engineer whose most recent country of citizenship or permanent residence is Japan. Deemed export license applications are submitted online using the Simplified Network Application Process Redesign, SNAP-R web portal. BIS has training videos available on the BIS online training room for step-by-step instructions to use SNAP-R. Deemed export license applications require additional supporting documents, such as a letter of explanation, complete job description, foreign person's resume including particular qualifications, a technology control plan, and proof of eligibility to work in the United States. Similar to conventional exports, deemed export license applications are subject to an interagency review process. Once the deemed export is authorized, either under a license exception, or in situations where the item may be exported on a no license required basis, release of the technology or software source code may occur. There are deemed re-exports too. Section 734.14 of the EAR defines a deemed re-export as the release in a foreign country of technology or source code subject to the EAR to a foreign person of another country. For example, if U.S. origin technology is exported to France and a national from India will be hired to work at the French facility, then the French company might need to apply for a deemed re-export license to release the technology to the Indian national. The same license review process occurs, including the determination of the individual's most recently obtained citizenship or permanent residency. Here are a few points about deemed exports. The deemed export and deemed re-export provisions are described in Part 734 of the EAR. To get to Part 734, navigate to the BIS website at bis.doc.gov. Hover the mouse over Regulations from the blue menu bar and select Export Administration Regulations. On the next page, scroll down and click on Part 734, Scope of the Export Administration Regulations. Additional information on deemed exports is available under the Policy Guidance tab of the BIS website. Deemed exports do not apply to U.S. citizens, lawful permanent residents, or other protected individuals. And the State Department, Directorate of Defense Trade Controls, also regulates releases of technology subject to the International Traffic in Arms Regulations to foreign persons in the United States and abroad. Please consult DDTC's website at www.pmddtc.state.gov for additional information. As always, the Bureau of Industry and Security's Office of Exporter Services is here to help. Please feel free to contact us if you have any further questions. Thank you for watching this video, and happy exporting!